The Uganda National Examinations Board, UNEPAS, launched the first ever examination under the new lower secondary curriculum, NLSC. Candidates across the country began writing mathematics paper 1 at 9 a.m. today, with chemistry paper 1 in the afternoon. Speaking during the weekly joint security briefing at the police headquarters in Naguru, Kampala, UNEP spokesperson Jennifer Kalule Musamba warned against involvement in cheating, stating that UNEP is closely monitoring all centers.
Ekyayo lwaleero tusobodde okutandika ekigezo eky'omwaka guno ekya curriculum empya, era nga abayizi baffe batandise n'okuwandika ekigezo eky'okubala paper 1. Tunayo abayizi 98 ku senta eyeluzira, nga omu ku baana abayizi wa myaka 6, era nga abayizi bano bonna bakola curriculum empya.
UNEP has taken firm steps to prevent examination malpractice, partnering with security agencies and deploying over 1,200 scouts across the country. This year is historic for UNEP as it conducts two sets of Uganda Certificate of Education UCE exams concurrently. The Ugandan government and the Turkish construction firm Yapı Merkezi have today signed a contract to build 270-kilometer standard gauge railway, SGR. The project is expected to cost Uganda a total of 10.8 trillion shillings and is aimed at boosting regional trade and improving connectivity between Uganda and her neighbors in the East African community. Works and Transport Minister General Edward Katumba Wamala acknowledged the achievement so far reached by the country and pointed out the immense benefits.
The idea really, the whole thing behind, was to enable trade, facilitate trade, movement of goods and people faster, safer, and more affordable.
Dr. Eden Arioglu, the vice chairperson Yapı Merkezi, signed on behalf of the Turkish firm, while Works Ministry Permanent Secretary Engineer Wiswava Geya signed on behalf of Uganda. Minister Katumba urged the contractors to consider purchasing materials, if possible, from local manufacturers, emphasizing that many of them meet ISO certification.
We don't want Yapı to go looking for people from outside to come and cook food for the workers. That's a local content. As you heard in my speech, I told them cement. We have companies here which are already certified by ISO standards. Iron bars, we have companies which are certified. Stones, we don't want to see them going to Kenya to bring stones.
The rail will run from Malaba to Kampala, connecting Uganda to Kenya's rail network and on to the Indian Ocean seaport of Mombasa. Opposition MPs have vowed to block any additional supplementary funds for Roko Construction Limited. This comes after Parliament's Leader of Opposition, LOP Joel Senyonyi, and a team of lawmakers were reportedly denied access to the company's premises today. Accompanied by lawmakers, Senyonyi arrived at the company premises, hopeful they would be allowed in. However, they were met by a closed gate. After more than 10 minutes, it became clear that the company was being evasive, prompting LOP Senyonyi to threaten to storm their offices for answers. This sparked a heated exchange between him and the head of security, who claimed to have orders from his bosses.
What we have got is that they replied to you that you are not welcome today with your team.
Why aren't we welcome here? Because taxpayers' money has been injected here.
I'm not supposed to answer such a question, sir. I'm very sorry. I have a copy of the letter.
I'm seeing this letter here.
The first
reference is made to your letter dated 8th. Mm-hmm. It's addressed to myself, the opposition, and so on. Mm-hmm. Is the director around? The one who wrote this letter?
I think you have his contact. You can contact.
No, I don't have his contact.
After failing to resolve the standoff, Senyonyi left the premises, lamenting that he had been denied his rightful duty. Senyonyi, in late February this year, was barred from accessing the construction site of Lubowa Specialized Hospital for lack of protective gear. This infuriated Speaker Anita Annette Among, who later delegated her deputy, Thomas Tayebwa.
As you can see, they have denied us access to, first of all, they denied us access to enter. It's only that they opened for a car to get out, and so we moved in a little bit, but still they told us you can't go beyond a particular point.